The Aquino family and their supporters are marking the third death anniversary of former President Noynoy Aquino at the Manila Memorial Park. Our very own Willard Chang is there, and he joins us now with that story. Willard, over to you.
Hi, Casey. Aquino family and friends gathered at Manila Memorial Park to remember former President Benigno Aquino III on his third death anniversary. Father Jet Villarin celebrated the Mass in honor of Pinoy and remembered in his homily how the former president dedicated his life to serve especially the marginalized. Speaking on behalf of the Aquino family, Pinoy's nephew, Kiko Aquino D., recalled how his uncle lived by the principle, right is might, as he fought for the rights of the country in the West Philippine Sea that led to the 2016 arbitral ruling, which has become vital in asserting the Philippines' rights, and which also meant respect for the Constitution, peace in the Bangsamoro, and his fight against corruption and good governance. Aquino D. said, this, in a sense, applies as well to the struggle for justice of former Senator Laila De Lima. Aquino D. urged those present to continue finding ways to serve the Filipino people. In fact, among those who were present in today's commemoration was former Senator Laila De Lima, who joined the commemoration for the first time since her liberty. She described Aquino as a good man and a good leader who believed and did not lose faith in her. In fact, ahead of De Lima's hearing in Muntinlupa RTC, one of the prayers of the faithful said in today's Mass was for De Lima to obtain justice and fairness after what was described as years of oppression. Let's listen to former Senator Laila De Lima.
Wala po si Pinoy, nasa loob po ako, nakakulong po ako, and I was so shocked nung nalaman ko, pinadala na ko ng note ng aking staff na namatay na si Pinoy, dahil hindi ko alam, may sakit pala siya, kasi nung bibisita siya sa akin, di naman halata na may sakit siya. So nung nakaraang anniversaries, this is now the third anniversary, hindi ko talaga... Ang sakit na naman sa kalooban ko na hindi man lang ako makapunta dito. And now that I'm free, and so nandito ako, so tuwang-tuwa ako dahil ako si Pinoy. But I miss him so much. He's such a good man, he's such a good leader, na ang dami kong natutunan sa kanya.
Also, those scenes in today's commemoration were former Senators Franklin Villon and Bam Aquino, and members of the Aquino cabinet. Back to you, Casey.
Thanks a lot. Willard Chang there joining us on the line. Motorists will have to brace for another big increase in petroleum products this week. Diesel prices will see the biggest jump of a peso and 75 centavos per liter. Gasoline will increase by 1 peso and 40 centavos. Kerosene all set for a more than 1 peso hike. The Energy Department attributes the second straight oil price hike to the Middle East conflict and the rising demand for petroleum products. The Philippine Coast Guard insists government is not downplaying the escalating tensions in the West Philippine Sea. Executive Secretary and National Maritime Council's Chairperson Lucas Bersamin has drawn flak for saying China's latest act of aggression against Philippine troops in Ayungin Shoal is not an armed attack. The incident was caught on tape, showing China's use of force to stop a Philippine resupply mission. A Filipino serviceman also lost a finger during that incident. The PCG says government remains committed to fighting China's aggression, but only through peaceful means.
Hindi nagbago ang guidance ng ating Pangulo. Ito ay issue na dapat hindi natin paabutin sa ganyang level. We still want to negotiate peacefully itong kaguluhan na nangyari sa resupply mission na to ng BRP Sierra Madre last June 17, sir. With respect kay Executive Secretary Bersamin, I think what he really meant is something na kailangan niya pa talagang explain sana further. I do believe and I do respect Executive Secretary Bersamin na hindi niya naman dina-downplay no, ang pangyayaring ito.
Commodore Jay Tariela also defending their recommendation to President Marcos to make China and the whole world aware of the country's future resupply missions to the BRP Sierra Madre, the country's lone outpost in the West Philippine Sea.
Kung sakali man na ma-approve ito ng ating Pangulo, we should not see it na ito ay intention para magpaalam sa China, no? But we should see it this way. Ang announcement ng resupply mission natin will be covered by all countries in the world. So we are going to once again put the spotlight on China, whether they're going to carry out another escalatory or aggressive action or inhumane action. This will give more burden for China to adhere to the international law and to be careful, no, in respecting the sovereign rights of our country as we do the resupply mission.